celebration, we decided to give away pieces of artwork at an auction during the cocktail hour. Our guests purchased the free artwork with money we printed and gave to them upon their arrival. We called this my money. After all, it was my party. Since we had a captive audience, we provided information about the Children's Hearing Institute and other charitable organizations. In the end, everyone went home with something beautiful to hang on the wall, and more importantly, an awareness of the great things that were happening at the Children's Hearing Institute. The auction was a great success in delivering the message to our closest friends and family. I do not want people to feel obligated to contribute, but I wanted those who might set aside money each year for charitable organizations, for charitable contributions, to consider the Children's Hearing Institute. I want to thank all of those from the bottom of my heart and ears who have contributed greatly to my cause and who are sitting amongst us tonight. I would also like to thank all of the corporate sponsors who have supported my endeavor, such as Citibank, D'Agostino Supermarket, IBM, AI Freeman, and Starbucks, to name a few. For me, I consider this the beginning of my quest. I am presently designing a website for those who are considering a cochlear implant, or those who already received one, to chat and share their thoughts, ideas, and feelings about their experience. In this way, hearing impaired kids and their parents will be able to get information, ask questions, and get an unbiased view of what it's actually like to get an implant. I am also currently looking for more corporate sponsors to support the website and consider donating each year to the Children's Hearing Institute. I would like to thank a few special people who have helped to change my life. Dr. Ronald Hoffman, who skillfully performed my surgery. Dr. Jane Maydell, who has tested and tested and retested my hearing over the years and kept me going with fantastic hearing aids and recommending the implant. Lois Heyman, whom I call Aunt Lois, who started as my speech therapist and who is now truly part of my family, who explained everything there is to know about cochlear implants and who has taught me how to speak as eloquently as I do today. Nikki, Lily, and everyone else from the audiology department at Beth Israel Hospital. My parents, who love me from head to toe and who would never ever let me give up or miss my speech lessons, especially when I wanted to go to soccer or play with my friends after school. My brother Sam and my sister Becky, who are always there for me when I need them. Thank you to my Nana, my relatives, and all our close family friends for supporting me tonight. I also want to thank my best friends for coming tonight to help celebrate this special evening with me. Lastly, I would like to thank Cochlear America, who has provided support and public relations to help spread the word about cochlear implants. Being a little bit different is not so bad. It adds another dimension and a little interest to my life. Besides, look at all the great people I have met along the way. Sometimes when I start feeling sorry for myself, when I feel down, or when I say, why me? I remember a line from a Beatles song, all you need is love. I also think that God must have a real purpose for me. Thank you. Oh.